Hello again, I'm Yalda Hakim. You're watching Impact from the BBC. Let's just give you more now on our top story in the developments today around North Korea's nuclear program and the proposed summit between President Trump and Kim Jong-un. Joining me here in the studio is John Hemmings, director of the Asia Studies Center at the Henry Jackson Society. John, thanks so much for joining us here on the program. Let's talk first about this tour that the journalists are making, quite an arduous journey that they're taking. We heard there from one of the correspondents. And interesting that it's journalists being taken, not weapons inspectors.
Yes, I think we can take from this exactly what it is. It's spin for the moment. It's the North Koreans trying to represent what's obviously a kind of physical failure of the site as a kind of concession. And that's fine that they do that, but I don't think we should feel that it is a real concession. I mean, I think they are bringing them in to do a specific job, which is to message the West about North Korea.
Tell us about this site, because frankly, last September it was deemed unusable. So what's actually happening?
Well, we know that the physical structures have begun to collapse just due to the repeated tests. We've seen the massive spike in missile tests under Kim Jong-un. I think they more than quadrupled what were previously done under Kim Jong-il and Kim Il-sung. So it's obviously that the space has just taken too much. I think what it does also lead to some extent, an examination of what North Korea's positioning really is about. Are they intending to do something as they've promised at the Olympics and with South Korea President Moon Jae-in? Or is this all theatrics? Are they trying to build up a case to show why the failure was Donald Trump's fault? We'll soon see.
Because skeptics have been saying all along, look, we've seen these games being played by them before, so don't just jump in and try and meet Kim Jong-un, you know, without understanding exactly their position.
There is definitely there's a very repetitive nature to this. If you follow North Korea enough, you begin to see the patterns very quickly. Often surprise concessions after really years of non-meetings and, you know, stubbornness at the table. So whether or not John Bolton was truly the case for the near walkout or the near cancellation of last week's summit, I still don't even know to this day. I mean, we could suspect all we want. What we do know is they have a very sophisticated team of diplomats who have had long decades of experience working with us, whereas we have, you know, presidential administrations
cycles
come and go.
Come and go.
But
they also haven't dealt with a president like President Trump, and we've now got the vice president saying, hey, don't play games with him. He could pull out as well.
Donald Trump has been interesting for a lot of U.S. foreign policy watchers. He's, to some extent, everything's on the table. And also he tries to navigate his different business deals right across different sectors. I still suspect, and some people suspect, that North Korea's near cancellation may have been part of the U.S.-China relationship, a result, for example, of sanction busting by the Xi Jinping government, which was a bit annoyed with the trade wars. So we're in new space, we're in new territory, whereas previous administrations would try to separate various aspects of the relationship. We're seeing these things beginning to bleed into each other. The question is whether he's wily enough and well briefed enough to be able to know which of the calls takes priority for U.S. national interest.
And for people like yourself who are watching all of this very closely, is there a chance that this summit could not actually happen?
I think so. I think there. So the optimist in me thinks that there is a chance that all they want is not to be compared to Libya. All they want is step taken by the U.S. In other words, every step towards denuclearization is matched in some way, and they don't want to be out of control of the relationship. But then the pessimist in me does say, well, we have been here before.
We'll have to wait and see over the next few weeks how this develops. John, thanks so much for joining us again on the program.
Thank you.